I guess we better get out and fix it. What are you getting so worked up about?
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Dude, is this a sign or what? I've heard nothing but bad things about this place. Chow is awful, racks are uncomfortable. Don't even get me started on
it. Just help me get the jack and the spare out of the
trunk. Why don't you just call it in?
It'd be a hell of a lot easier, you know.
I'm not gonna call it in. My first day assigned to a new base.
All right, whatever you say.
Come on.
You know, it is beautiful out here. I heard there's some hiking out here that is great.
Well, there you go, Sergeant. It's not that bad after all.
Are they supposed to be running tests today?
Not that I'm aware of. Go, Sergeant.
Slow down, small fry. I haven't run in months.
Well-being of our children is one of our greatest concerns. We strive to give them every opportunity in life. I am honored to represent the President at the dedication of what will be a cornerstone in the foundation of our children's health for many generations to come. The first of many, I hope.
Stagecoach, I need immediate extract. I say it again, immediate extract.
We need to get you safety right now, Madam Vice President.
Mr. Taylor, what's our situation?
Western Air Defense Sector reported an unidentified aircraft estimated at 1 kilometer in length entered our airspace at 0700 hours, Mr. President. Air assets are already en route. Early reports describe the aircraft as a beehive, sir.
Reports? We don't have a visual in here?
Negative. Something seems to be interfering with some of our satellite relays. Civilian channels are up, ours are down. NORAD is trying to get us in the air. As of right now, all we have are eyes on the ground doing their best to forward whatever first-hand intel they can get.
Take us to DEFCON 3. I'm not messing around. How's NORAD doing?
They switched to backup channels to deploying now, sir.
Great, we need all the assets at the ready. It's like provocation, I'm gonna blow this thing from the sky. Is the Vice President of the Virginia bunker?
Yes, sir, the Vice President has just arrived.
Great. Vice President Rainey, we're 200 feet below the surface in a fully sustainable habitat that can withstand a direct hit from nuclear warhead. This is Captain Goddard, Bioweapons Division.
Vice President Rainey.
Captain Goddard, why is Bioweapons Division here?
He's here at the request from the President.
Have they exhibited any threatening actions as of yet?
No, ma'am. Not as of yet.
Tactical Air Command has just relayed that two jets are on approach to intercept the spaceship.
Alpha Bravo, Raptor 311. We're on approach to target now. Getting a fair amount of turbulence in its wake. Rabbit, why don't you hang back, just in case?
Roger that.
One mile to target. I'm I'm beginning to see surface detailing now. Protrusions, plating, materials unknown. No visible windows or hatches.
Jesus.
I'm gonna descend to 17,000, have a look underneath.
Sets are clear to engage. And get that damn satellite up there. I need to see this thing.
Approaching target. Alpha Bravo, we now have multiple targets inbound.
Zone reports all of our conventional assets are failing, Mr. President. All of our efforts are failing.
I'm declaring DEFCON 1 clear to go nuclear.
Facility MX2 has just been attacked, Mr. President. There's been no detonation, but the systems are showing offline. Our launch has failed, sir.
It's right on top of us, sir! Everybody get out, now! Let's go!
Evacuate the PDOC, everyone out!
I'm not leaving you, sir.
Out! Just leave.
I'm not leaving you.
Just leave, go!
Oh my God.
What is it, Ari?
The White House. It's been attacked. No survivors, including President Oliver.
Ari, do you have confirmation?
Yes, Vice.
Under the Federal Continuity Directive, ensuring the continuous performance of the essential functions of our government during time of war, I will need to swear you in, Vice President Rainey.
I do solemnly swear that I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States and will, to the best of my ability, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
The country is now in your hands. What are your orders, Madam President?
Lexi, relax. Get your finger up there, put this on your shoulder, get your leg back, your foot back.
Stop shooting!
What is it, Red?
You gotta come listen to this.
This morning, not more than 20 minutes ago, the White House was attacked. We are standing at DEFCON 1. Although no nuclear launches have been confirmed at this time, over 2,000 people work in the White House, and evacuation was in process. Hold on. President Oliver is dead. We now have confirmation that President Oliver was in the bunker.
Wasn't your brother assigned to the president's detail?
Yeah. Folks, yeah, he was.
Well, I don't know. Maybe. Maybe he was off the president's detail.
I kept up with him through the ex. She just said last week he was still assigned to Oliver.
I'm sorry, Kelly. He was a good kid.
Break silence. Contact all the militia chapters. We're going to war. These aliens picked the wrong planet to mess with.
Today, we not only as Americans, but as creatures of the Earth, are under attack.
Nuclear assets haven't any success.
Negative, President Rainey. They've all failed. Same with the other nuclear nations. All ordnance has just been frozen.
Okay. Stand down from DEFCON 1. Go to 2.
Meredith, what are you doing?
Our nuclear assets aren't working, Randall.
Well, we can't stop trying.
It's not working, Randall. And the more we try, the greater the potential we destroy ourselves in the process. The fact that they only disabled them gives me hope.
Yeah, Dad. Maybe they felt threatened that our jet fighters approached.
They may have, son. But the fact remains, they attacked...
We're receiving a transmission! It's coming from the Hive.
Put it on.
People of the third planet, we shall refer to ourselves as Orions. As our planet resides in a solar system much like your own, within the constellation of stars you call Orion, it is not our intent to destroy you. Our mission is one of peace, but your race is a violent one. And for this reason, we must guarantee our safety. Therefore, we have eliminated the threat of your nuclear weapons in the next 2 hours. All other remaining military installations and government capitals will be destroyed. In time, you will receive further instruction.
How the hell is that a mission of peace?
Ari, was that communication on an open channel?
No, ma'am. I tried to place a lock on it, but I was unable to grab it.
I want to open a dialogue with them. Make this happen.
Yes, Madam President.
I need to address the nation. Let the people know what's happening. I need a few minutes to compose my thoughts.
Dark Echo is still 2 hours out, Madam President.
Thank you. And may we remain ever vigilant and strong. Just as our country has done countless times before, we will get through this. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America.
President, the Kremlin has been destroyed, as well as the Kantai, both British and French parliaments.
Thank you.
We're receiving another transmission.
Can you identify the frequency signature?
Still trying, Madam President.
All governments and military installations worldwide have now been destroyed. You have ravaged your world too long. We will provide you the chance to restart on a new world. Momentarily, transport ships will begin arriving in all capitals and cities, with populations in excess of 1 million people. Go to them. Everything else will be provided for you. You have 120 hours to evacuate your planet. At the end of this period, all remaining humans will be exterminated. You will not survive this. Go. Now.
They expect us to evacuate a planet of 7 billion people in just 5 days. They're out of their minds.
People are already lining up to board the ships. Seats on my phone.
Why would they destroy all our weapons, but keep civilian communications open?
They're taking prisoners. That's what they're doing. That's 25 confirmed ships so far. Members on alert across Pennsylvania. Let's head into Philly. When we find the location of the ship, we attack.
I've got it. I've isolated the Orion's frequency signature. Okay, Madam President. Try to speak at a slightly slower than normal pace. Avoid any overt emotions just because the Matrix may scramble your intentions on their end and spit out the wrong words or symbols. Unfortunately, there's no way to translate our language from our end.
I bring you greetings from the United States of America. I am President Meredith Rainey. We wish to open a peaceful dialogue with your leaders. We regret if our initial actions were taken as offensive and caused you to defend yourselves. It was not our intent to display aggression. I request
we open a channel of dialogue so that we may convey our desire
for peaceful and harmonious relations between our two races.
They're responding.
You attacked us.
Again, it is common procedure to send jets in the air.
We are open to dialogue. However, our intent will remain unchanged. You have 119 hours in which to evacuate your planet.
We are grateful for your help. However, we are a race that is intrinsically suspicious. Therefore, to allay our fears, we need some form of proof to substantiate your claims to aid us.
We will prove our intentions by demonstrating our technological and medical superiorities with your race. There are places in your world where people suffer from starvation. We will feed them. Your race is plagued by diseases. We will offer cures. These are but only a few gifts awaiting your peaceful surrender.
I don't like it, Meredith. What, for us to give up everything? Get on a ship and go to a foreign world? This proves nothing.
President Rainey, you have a son.
Yes. That is correct.
In further effort to prove our intentions, you will go to the transport ship in Washington, D.C. There, we will heal him.
Heal me?
Sweetheart.
You don't know what these things might do to you, Bobby.
To me? But what are they gonna do to all of us?
Sweetheart, we can't risk having you part of some experiment.
Mom, if they're not trustworthy, then we're already dead.
Nobody here to greet us, because unless we know about them, the more strategic advantage they have over us.
Let's go, buddy.
Perhaps you can accompany them, obtain a little intel.
Yes, sir.
You don't need to go through with this, Bobby.
Yeah, I do.
I think it's best you remain here, Madam President.
I can accompany the Madam President.
Sign her first, sir. Check things out.
Halt. Weapons detected. These items are not allowed aboard this vessel. You must remove them immediately. You have 5 seconds to comply. Scanning. Bring us the child of President Raimi. We will heal him. Bring the child to us.
The ship must be equipped with some sort of surveillance. It knew that Goddard was armed.
Well, they either didn't catch the camera or they didn't mind us taking a peek.
as the child of President Rainey. We will heal him. Bring the child to us. Bring the child to us. Bring the child to us.
They're asking for him, sir. It appears safe as far as I can tell.
Remember when I used to pitch in Little League?
Of course I do.
That was really good.
Let's go. Come on.
Sensory of some kind.
Right.
You will proceed to the regeneration chamber. There we will repair your body. Continue. Continue. Assist the child into the regeneration chamber. Process complete.
Are you all right? Come on.
Hey, slow. Take your time. Hey. All right.
Stop staring at me.
Sorry. You'll feel a lot better once we get the doctor to completely check you out.
Mom, I feel great. Honestly.
I'm glad.
Guys, I think it's a good idea we don't stick around here too long. It's dangerous.
Perhaps you're right.
Madam President?
Yes, Jim.
I've got some important new developments that I'd like to discuss with you.
Go on.
Can we step over there?
Very well.
All right. Ari discovered an encrypted signal hidden within a natural occurring CMB radiation in deep space. Before the arrival of the Orions, this signal was not being detected. Furthermore, its source of origin is nowhere near the Orion's constellation.
They're lying.
Can we listen in on this deep space channel?
We could, Madam President, but not from here. If we can go back to the bunker, I can access it through the mainframe. I can try and upgrade the logic gate matrix and then run the signal through the virtual machine. There's a slight chance we might be able to decipher their language.
Slight chance is better than no chance. Let's go.
Flanking David and Michael, keep the perimeter secure. I don't want any civilians getting past.
Halt.
How is that smell?
Holy shit.
Weapons detected.
Hold steady, Lexi.
It's going to shoot us.
Get down! Take cover!
Oh my god, it's so bad. It's so bad.
Oh, no.
The Philadelphia transport ship is under attack, and I have reports of the same thing in Houston and Atlanta.
By who?
A militia group calling themselves First Earth, and I have reports of riots in other cities. People are pushing past barricades and boarding the ships.
What do we know about First Earth?
It's a United Militia Front led by a Kelly Reed.
I know that is. He's Agent Norman Reed's brother, former Army Ranger.
Left the service, became a freelance contractor. Now he heads up the Pennsylvania Militia, and we're in.
Whoa, this thing looks crazy. You sure you can work on this, Ari?
I think so.
Mobilize the National Guard. I want this faction taken down now. And I want all hands on deck to keep civilians off those ships.
Oh, why? After all, they did heal me, didn't they?
Let's not forget, their first move was to destroy the White House. The fact remains they've yet to tell us where they're taking our people. And until they do, I'm not letting anyone on those ships. What is it, Ari?
We have a message coming through from the Orions.
What's the problem with that?
I don't want to add any stress to the virtual machine.
I think we should hear what they have to say.
What's the worst it could do?
The most simple way is to think of when a wire takes too much current, it explodes. The heat has to go somewhere. The whole mainframe could shut down.
They could be launching another attack after First Earth's antics.
Put it through, Ari.
Several of our transport ships have come under attack in the United States and suffered damages. It appears people are not being allowed to board our ships. We are prepared to withdraw all extraction efforts and commence with immediate extermination procedures in the United States.
We were unaware of the attacks on your vessels. They were committed by a faction outside our government. We will put a stop to them immediately.
This is acceptable. You will allow your people to board our ships.
No. No, I will not. Not until you tell us where they are being taken.
They're gone, Madam President.
Reports are coming in from all over the country. People are boarding the ships. After the world saw what happened to Bobby, it's a matter of trust. We won't be able to keep these people off those ships.
The mainframe is overloading.
Well, whatever it is you're doing, just shut it down.
The whole system is failing.
That's life support.
The issue isn't environmental control. The system is no longer venting oxygen.
Well, how long do we have?
I don't know what's happening. I should be able to...
We only have a few minutes before we run out of air.
I'm trying to restart the system, but the override valve is jammed.
What do we do?
Somebody has to go all the way down to EC and fix it manually. Then I can reboot it from here.
I know where it is. I'll need all hands just in case. Let's go.
Go!
You stay. Stay with the president.
Yes, sir.
I'll be back.
Bobby!
You okay?
Yeah, go. Go.
This is it. Madam President.
Isn't there anything you can do, Ari?
No, President, any. We just have to hope they radio back to us before it's too late.
Over here! This way! Right here!
Under the bridge?
Okay, let's do it!
Ready, go!
Here it is.
Here. It's stuck!
Look, there's a pipe. General, use this for leverage.
I can't.
Let me try, sir.
I can't
You guys all right? Okay.
It's over.
Seems the rest of the life support systems are returning to normal.
General, get Bobby up to the main level.
Dad, I'm fine.
Go!
Yeah.
This is Kelly Reed.
Who's asking?
This is Senator Randall Rainey.
You know, you're making quite a mess out there.
I want to know why you're attacking the transport ships.
It's an attack on American soil, Senator.
Well, look, I was thinking if we could work together, maybe we could solve this problem.
This conversation's over.
Mr. Reed, the president is ordering the National Guard and local law enforcement
around the country to shut you down by whatever means necessary. Now, I can call those hounds off if you help me.
Mr. Reed, I think we both have the same goal in mind here.
What do you want?
Look, there's a great deal of suspicion what the Orion's true intentions are.
We don't know where they're taking our people, and we don't want any more people getting on the ships.
So you need some kind of deterrent, something that will make the people stay away.
That's where you guys would come in.
Can we do this?
We can probably help with that.
How do you feel?
I'm fine. How about you?
Did we make any progress?
Ari's transferring everything he was able to download before the system crashed. General Roundtree, you were able to relay my orders to the National Guard.
Yes, Madam President.
Loose your weapons. We're going in unarmed this time.
We'll see if the security scan can pick up on these. Cops aren't going to be able to keep those crowds at bay for long. Ever since they healed the president's kid, they all want to get on those ships.
Can't let that happen.
When we first step in, that laser is gonna scan us. Assuming we make it past the first laser, we'll split up, plant the C4, and meet back here in 10 minutes to detonate. Understood?
Roger that.
Move out.
Halt. Scanning.
Everyone's unarmed, right?
You may proceed.
Look for any instrument panels or imperfections in the hull.
Doesn't pick up that plastic, huh?
Not so far.
Is that smell, man?
I don't know. What I'm worried about is getting the plastic caps on here. These ought to do some damage.
Wait, do you hear that?
Weapons detected.
There's been another attack on the Philadelphia transport ship. It's First Earth again. Mass casualties this time. Madam President, the Orions are contacting us.
Crap. Make sure the National Guard and local law enforcement understand their duties, General.
Yes, ma'am.
Put them on.
President Rainey, you have failed us. There have been further attacks.
An isolated incident. I assure you, it is being dealt with.
We are prepared to withdraw extraction efforts and proceed with extermination procedures.
Please, do not do that. We are doing everything.
They terminated the connection, President Rainey. Reports of Orions attacking and firing on crowds.
Raise the Orions, Ari.
Yes, ma'am.
They're not responding.
Keep trying.
Madam President, Ministry of Defense.
Hello, Minister Brighton. Yes. Yes, I understand your position. We are doing everything that we can to suppress the actions of First Earth. Yes, sir. Hold on one second. Minister Brighton, an urgent matter has taken place. I need to call you back.
Hello?
What the hell happened out there, Reed?
It's Fubar, sir.
The people pushing their way in with the cops in tow and the freaking lasers dropped.
Well, this is not what I had in mind.
They don't appear to be shooting civilians. I apologize, sir. What do you want us to do?
Just stand down for the moment.
Talking without here, Randall. General Roundtree just spoke to the captain in charge of the National Guard detail. They received orders to assist First Earth from you?
I made a bad move, Meredith. I asked them
to do what they could to keep people off the ships.
Dark Echo has arrived.
Easy to follow orders when you agree with them, Senator.
President Rainey, I'm Major Fry. This is Lieutenant Zuber from the 45th Space Wing, Extraterrestrial Avionics Intelligence Unit.
We believe this is what we're up against.
On August 14th, 2003, the sun released a larger-than-normal plasma tendril, resulting in a massive electromagnetic explosion. It downed all satellite, radio, and cellular communications.
That's the same date as the East Coast blackouts.
That's correct, Captain. It turns out our friend here was paying us a visit as well.
What makes you think this is the race that's attacking us?
A unique signature in the cosmic microwave background radiation. Our team detected a similar signal when the Hive arrived this morning.
Our technician, Mr. Ari, has identified a CMB encryption signal. We'll be happy to share that with you.
Hey, we smelled an odor when Bobby was healed on the transport ship, and the guys in the field are smelling something on other transport ships as well.
We learned from the Cheyenne ship that that odor is a sort of chemical pheromone. It enables access to vital components of the ship. Our chemists were able to replicate that formula in the laboratory. We call it CH5N. We should be able to use it to access restricted areas of the alien vessels. But it's impossible to say for certain without a more recent specimen.
Now, I think it would be fitting for you to use your militia, Randall.
I'm sorry. Say that again?
Yeah, I want you to capture an Orion.
And how are we supposed to do that, Senator?
There was a firefight over the Virginia mountains this morning. If you go digging in the wreckage, you might find a pilot. It could be dead or alive, it makes no difference.
Well, I might know a couple of mountain boys. Leave it to us, sir. We'll do our best.
They're gonna do it.
Good. Major Fry, let's get you over to the DC transport ship. See what you make of it.
Certainly, Madam President.
I've been analyzing the Orion signal from the CMB and comparing it against another signal that I found embedded from the broadcast in the mothership. So far, I've isolated about 30 unique patterns that keep showing up. It seems that this is their alphabet.
Impressive work. On the Cheyenne ship, we tried to broadcast that CMB signal. The controls would flutter like an energy pulse. Didn't get us anywhere.
We've had several English broadcasts to line these patterns up against. It's not going to be perfect, but I do have a translator algorithm for us to try and access this database.
Pheromone should get us access. Hopefully your alphabet will get us some answers.
General, what do we know about their boarding procedures?
Ship is equipped with some sort of a weapons detection system.
A laser turret enforces a no-tolerance policy. We're not quite sure how they're surveilling their ship.
Understood. Let's see what they make of this. Whatever their surveillance, I'm willing to bet with CH5N, they'll look the other way. Lieutenant. Sir.
proceed.
Same as the Cheyenne ship. Unlike the vessel recovered in O3, this ship doesn't appear to be designed for manned flight. Looks like it's trying to establish a link. See what it's trying to say.
How do we even know one of those alien bastards is out here?
We don't.
That's great news, Mr. Reed. Text me your coordinates. I'm sending a chopper to you. We have ourselves an Orion. Dr. Goddard, have you ever done an autopsy?
Yes, I have. Carbon-based life form. Oxygen and nitrogen present in their blood suggest they breathe a similar atmosphere to ours. Same alkaline-based cell structure, but with slightly different attributes. The first Earth-captured Orion has a more mesomorphic build, bigger and stronger. Cheyenne specimen, slightly thinner, more ectomorphic. But I'm willing to bet they're both symbiotes of the same colony, much like workers to a queen bee.
Major Fry, what happened?
Lasers dropped. I lost Lieutenant.
Are you hurt?
No, Madam President, I'm fine. Just need to wait for the AI to reset, and I'll try again.
Please be careful, Major.
Yes, Madam President. Okay, we try again. Be ready to move. Flight mission. Hmm.
navigation. Colonization. They're trying to colonize Earth-like planets. They're using the Hive to terraform them.
Can you find out where they're taking our people, Major?
Yes. Trajectory.
Just jettisoning the people into space.
I'm sorry, Major. Please repeat that. I didn't get it.
I said they are just jettisoning the people into space. Like throwing out the trash, President.
That can't be right. He said the ship first goes to the Hive.
Major, are you sure? Are you absolutely certain? No one appears to be getting off at the Hive.
Yes, Madam President. This has all been downloaded to my PAM. I'll show you when I return.
President Rainey, what about the people across the country waiting to board? Across the globe?
Let them board.
No. They're gonna die. We have to tell them. We can't let them board those ships.
We can't let them know we're on to them. We'd be giving up all our intel. Finally, we know something about them they don't want us to know. Have we gotten an update from Captain Goddard yet?
I spoke to him a little earlier. He said he's making progress, but he'd prefer to explain it when he returns.
We better get back to the bunker. I want to know what I can about that alien.
Why are they doing this? This is what I don't understand. Why don't they just destroy us? Why bother with the deception?
Less manpower. Less chance of engagement on their behalf. Less loss of men. They're terraforming planets. The more destruction they cause, the more work they give themselves. Their plan is actually quite efficient, but what I don't understand is why they're returning to the Beehive first.
We better get back to the bunker. Less we need to prepare. But we will not give up!
Madam President, I have an idea. It's incredibly simple, but every test I've run seems to confirm it.
Have you made an analysis of the aliens?
Yes, Madam President. I've mapped most of its anatomy, NNS, and I believe I can create a highly contagious airborne pathogen, and we can infect them, just like passing on a cold.
Do it.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, the ships are filling up. People are pushing past the barricades and forcing their way in.
Thank you, soldier.
You're welcome, sir.
What if it's a nice place? The new world they promised. What if it's a great, new, alien place with things we've never seen? What if we're actually killing people by not letting them board their ships?
Do you really think there's a chance in hell of any of that being true?
No.
This is my home. My country. It's our world. It may be over, but I'm gonna fight to my last breath.
Damn right.
Damn right.
You're goddamn right.
Rally every militia group in every city.
It's time to blow up some more alien shit. Everything we got, for as long as we got it.
Good work out there, Major Fry. I'm sorry about the loss of your man. I will see to it he receives the highest posthumous merit.
Thank you, Madam President.
Captain Goddard. Please explain your pathogen.
Yes. Well, I've successfully developed an airborne replicating agent called GS-57B. It's cooking right now. It's highly contagious, and I believe if we can introduce it aboard the Hive, it'll be a successful weapon.
Could GS-57B have repercussions in humans? Are we at risk for catching it?
There is a risk. Now, the contagion can't replicate in our bodies, so it shouldn't be a problem. But there's no way of knowing for sure.
I believe we have no other choice. Our only problem is, how do we get it to them? How do we infect them?
We could outfit the DC transport ship with Captain Goddard's viral agent, send it back to the Hive, release it via a time-controlled device.
Sounds like a great idea, but why would the Hive bring a transport ship back aboard?
We infect the navigation system with a bug, make it appear the ship isn't functioning properly. It'll have to go back for maintenance.
Resurgence has had success just lobbing grenades and C4 timers into the ships, making them return.
We can't do that, General. The heat wave from the blast will kill off the viral agent.
I'll make a virus to infect the ship's computer. I'll get on it.
Thank you, Ari.
Yes, ma'am.
Captain, notify me at once when it's ready.
Yes, President Rainey. Clear. Three, two.
First Earth has launched attacks on transport ships in several major cities. Dallas, Atlanta, Miami, Chicago. Chancellor Kafka's demanding you put a halt to the violence, as is Prime Minister Avenir, President Casillas.
Let them, Ari, let them say what they will. It's not my concern at this point.
Yes, Madam President.
Madam President, the captain and I are ready.
Is that the contagion?
Yes, ma'am.
Very well. Let's go.
President Rainey, the Orions are contacting us.
Put it on.
President Rainey, other world leaders have cooperated peacefully. Still, the United States remains defiant. There are continued attacks on our ships. We had hoped to avoid...
Turn it off, Ari.
Yes, President Rainey.
We're in. So far, the pheromone is still allowing us access to the ship. I'm gonna upload the bug into the navigation system. Stand by.
The virus is set.
Got it. We
We are go on the GS-57B transponder. And we're go on our maintenance issue. Time to leave, Captain.
Madam President, Madam President, they're contacting us again.
This is President Rainey. You will meet with us immediately. You will meet with us immediately.
Yes, I heard you the first time. What is the purpose of this meeting?
Despite our warnings, you continue to resist us. Still, we are prepared to discuss the details of the relocation of your people.
All right. I will come to you.
What are you doing, Nerd? It's out of the question. I'll go.
We accept your terms. A transport ship will be sent to your location.
Thank you. I'll take Captain Goddard's contagion with me.
It would be too dangerous, Madam President.
No. They asked for me. I'm the only one who can get us on that ship. It's the perfect plan.
If we can get at least one of these aboard the Hive, that would be sufficient.
Meredith, I'll do it. The country needs you.
Mom.
Come on, come on.
Major Fry, I'd like for you to come with me. Your expertise may be applicable in some way. Captain Goddard, I request your accompaniment as well.
Yes, ma'am.
The captain and I will wear the CH-5N to conceal our presence.
Very well, gentlemen. Shall we go?
Madam President.
Guessing yourself, would you, Captain Goddard?
No, Presenter Rainey. It will work.
Good. It better.
Here you go, Madam President.
One of these is enough?
The pathogen is highly contagious. Now Major Fry and I will go aboard the ship and try to put a few of these on there.
Give a few to Agent Taylor as well.
Aerosols will distribute it throughout the ship, but you have to make direct contact with the Queen.
And how long before it takes effect?
Should be within minutes.
And I'll know?
Yes, Madam President. The effects are agonizing.
Very well. I'll just try to keep them talking.
Oh.
President Rainey. Follow the corridor to your left.
Let's go. That's the last of the GS-57B bombs.
I'm gonna see if I can jam the Orion CMB encrypted signal. Run some ship-to-ship interference in case things go south.
Welcome, President Rainey. Welcome to my hive.
Who is speaking? Is there one leader among you?
I am speaking, President Rainey.
Who are you?
I am the leader of this colony.
What is all this?
This is the fate of your people. Our voyage to Earth was long. Human blood is viable to replenish our energy stores.
You're killing all of them.
It is the natural way. One life ends and contributes to another cycle.
Then why have you brought me here?
You will allow your people to board our transport ships, and they will replenish our energy stores here.
Why would I help you? Why should I lead my people to their slaughter?
In 4 days, your people are going to be exterminated. Your race has always defied nature. You selfishly ravaged the planet. Imagine you were a species with no predator. You refuse to accept your place in the universe. Accept it now. We are your predator. Surrender.
Absolutely not.
We are prepared to offer you a barter. In exchange for your cooperation, you and your family will be spared. You will allow your people to board our transport ships, and you and your family will not be harmed.
And where will we be safe?
Here, aboard our ship. Until the extermination and terraforming is complete. This is acceptable.
You leave me no choice. You have a deal.
Most acceptable. You will allow four people to board our ships?
No. Not until I know my family is safe. Then we'll have a deal. On Earth, this is the universal gesture of friendship and agreement.
You will stop the attacks on our ships.
Just get us out of here, Major.
System override. Navigation override. Helm override.
Let's go. Captain Goddard!
Collapsing in every city.
Their defenses are good. General, can we scramble some jets?
Definitely.
Dragonfly in pursuit of the transport ship. Hang in there.
Thank you.
We all did it.